Walker University. The title today is On the Existence of Extremely Tailored Metrics.
Thank you very much. First of all, I'd like to thank the organizers for inviting me to this special activity of mathematics. And today I'd like to speak on the existence problem of here is the table of contents. First, I talk about the extreme scale value of the grand function conjecture. And secondly, I talk about the background material and text configuration, random statistics invariance, and characterization of this invariance in terms of spectral noise. And the third thing is orthogonality in relative stability. And asymptotic. Asymptotic relative choice stability and relative case stability. And finally, I talk about the program, program itself, its material version. There are three steps, step one and step two and step three. And so the setting up the MLB, the polarized arrest manifold. This means that the M is a n-dimensional compact connected complex manifold. L is a very ample line band, very ample line band. And what M means the Rth group of polymorphic automatism for M. And P is the algebraic torus in this automorphism group, such that T is either T max or T minimum, or more generally, T sits in between T min and in between T minimum and T maximum. Here, T minimum is the one parameter group generated by extremal scalar vector, and T max is a maximal algebraic torus in auto M containing this T minimum. And these two, T minimum and T maximum, is a very very typical torus in OTM. So now I'll talk about the Donaldson-Pierre-Nolz conjecture and this extremal scalar version, and also non-results on extremal scalar version. And Donaldson-Pierre-Nolz conjecture, this constant scalar covers the scalar version, and it's extremal scalar version. And ML is case stable. This is a conjecture. It's supposed to be a first chunk class of L admits a constant scalar covers the scalar. But it depends on the definition of case stability. Maybe it depends on the definition of case. And its extremal scalar version is forced by scalability. Also, I give some version. And this is ML is case stable relative to T, if and only if first chunk class of L admits an extremal scalar metric. Also, this conjecture depends on the definition of case stable relative to T. So I will explain later. And of course, this extremal scalar version implies constant scalar covers the scalar version, because by constant scalar covers case, T by setting T for T minimum. But in this case, constant scalar curvature, so case stable implies that extreme scalar vector field is trivial. So this is T for trivial group. Then k-step relative to a trivial group is nothing but just k-stability. So extreme scalar version implies constant scalar curvature scalar version. And let me talk about non-facts on extreme scalar version. This extreme scalar version is this conjecture. And there are easy directions and difficult directions. And for easy direction, this okay. So from this, yeah, to this, this is okay for T max. This is stability and stopper. And also okay for T minimum, hence for general T. This is submitted paper. Anyway, I think the easy case is also. But the difficult case is from upstairs to downstairs. See, this is the existence problem. The partial results are known. The Einstein's Calabi conjecture, Oban Calabi, this is a solution of Calabi conjecture for each semi-negative case. Also, positive rich case, Kellan-Einstein case for substance. One, two, also the Kellan-Einstein Polis case. And the Ransom's of the general polarization and toric surface case. And Chen Dublin Weber case of the extreme they prove the existence of extreme scalar metrics using the removal of similarity style to 7. And a very important thing is the existence of the extreme scalar metrics on the two-point drawing of PPC for anti-Kellan classes. But of course, this solved only partially. And let me talk about the background materials, test configuration of polar algebraic manifold, the Ransom practice invariant, and choke norm for defined WM data, and the capitalization of stack invariant, the Ransom stack invariant by the choke norm. And the test configuration, of the polar algebraic manifold. This is by Donaldson, also originally Tian's special degeneration. And that ML is called the test configuration for ML. If there exists a C-star equivalent projective morphism, so between varieties is a relatively very ample, or generally, they are to be ample with some additional conditions, lambda and L over M, satisfying the following conditions. C subtraction on M leads to a C subtraction on L, and the restricting to each fiber, non-central fiber, is isomorphic to the original polar algebraic manifold. And the point is this configuration, but this the fiber over zero has a very bad similarity, may have very bad similarity, and maybe non-diffuse. And And also, definition of test computation sometimes, usually relatively variable. So, usually L naught is variable on M naught. But in my case, I dropped this variableness. Just I assume that this ampli. So I use this relatively ampli with some additional condition. I talk about this plus some additional. This modification of the assumption is very important in my calculus. And the balance of tactics invariant is this the dimension of the space of the sections, and the gamma MPD is weight of the sixth action on this determinant part. Determinant section of this determinant of this space of sections, and let divide this gamma m by m times nn, and then we have a simple expansion. This is a expansion by Johnson, and this f1 f not is not so important in this way. F1 is the called Johnson tactics invariant for MF. And because this I see. I didn't. This later I will explain that F1 this negativity is corresponds to the phase stability. For all test configuration of ML, and the equality for Z and only if ML is a product configuration. Anyway, another thing is another thing very important. Chonor by Zhang, S Zhang. Let the M be the degree of M in this. So by using quaternion embedded by this linear system, M is embedded in this projective space. Let Bm be the space of section, and the Wm be the tensor space. Symmetric tensor product of dual of Bm. And tensor to the n plus 1 times. And let this one be the Chow form for the reduced cycle n on this projective space. So that the if we projectivize this element is the Chow point for the cycle n. Then the constant Chonor, this is defined by S Zhang. That is mapping from Wm to R, and this is a tone norm. You have a norm. But this norm doesn't come from a linear form of Wm. This is just a norm. And the very important thing is for tone norm is the you can characterize the back invariant in terms of the channel. So for this configuration law of ML, take the direct image, this is here means the direct image of L to the N. And this is identified with the fiber of this vector bundle over one. Then the C-state variant isomorphism. This is by this isomorphism is obtained by the solution with equivalent cells conjecture. This equivalent isomorphism induces the representation of C star to this GL. And by using the associated special linear representation, specialized to the special linear part of the new, we have the new SL that is C from C star to this SL. And in terms of the tonal, we could do mu sc. This is actually the tonal, orbit of tonal by this representation. And using tonal, we take the tonal of this thing and take its law. Mu s is a kind of energy. And let alpha m be the possible rational weight of the C star action by mu SL on the line boundary of this. Then by letting S to the minus infinity, we obtain the derivative of this energy. When S tends to minus infinity equals just to this alpha m, the weight of the C star action on the line. And also you have this asymptotic expansion. So then this F1 appears in this expansion. Of course, so you have gamma m over n into F0 plus F1 to the F0 plus you have this kind of expansion, but also we have this S tends to minus and to P S of alpha n Now, I'd like to talk about the orthogonality in relative stability. And orthogonality appears in the relative stability as in the study of stability. But orthogonality appears in different ways for asymptotic relative choice stability and also for relative phase stability. So there are mainly two cases. This is not bilinear, but piecewise bilinear. So asymptotic relative choice stability case, by abuse of terminology, where T and its unrunkered power in SLVM will be used interchangeably. And let GM be the deductive algebraic group, subgroup in ZMT. ZMT denotes the centralizer of T in SLVM. And GMPT, direct adjunct subgroup in ZMT, obtained as the orthogonal complement of T in ZMT. We then define ML is asymptotic choice relative to T. This to be the GM, the orbit is closed in WM for M sufficiently large. And the if, for instance, if T equal 1, then ZMT centralizer, ZMT is a centralized SLVM. And the orthogonal complement, then orthogonal complement, orthogonal complement of T in ZMT. But in this case, T equal 1, and ZMT is SLVM. So orthogonal complement of this in this is exactly SLVM. And we define GM, this define GM with the orthogonal complement of T in GMT. So in this case, GM equals SLVM. Then ML is asymptotically choice-stable relative to the trivial group is nothing but the GM is proof special linear group. That is the ordinary choice stability, asymptotic choice stability. So and so this is a generalization of so usual asymptotic choice stability to be relative choice. And so orthogonality in relative choice stability case is let BM be the express BM as a direct sum of V, chi, and chi k. This is a weight decomposition. The V, chi k is a special all element in Vm on which this T acts by multiplication by chi k at I. Yeah. And put Hm be the direct product of SLV chi k. So, for instance, if V, for instance, if Vm is V pi 1, V pi 2, V pi 3, then the Hm, then Hm is the product. So actually, so you have three sectors. And this is SLV V pi 1, SLV pi 2, SLV pi 3. So, something like this. And GMPG product of GMBD product of HM and T pub. Yes, the owner component T pub is defined as follows. Let delta M be the group of all diagonal matrices in SLBM, acting on each D party as a constant scalar multiplication. So in this case, delta M be the this is lambda from the and SLBM and acting on each departure as a constant scalar matrix. And then ZM, then ZM is just HM times ZM. But we take a smaller group, define D pub as an algebraic subtorus in ZM, whose the algebra is the orthogonal complement of D. In part of DT in delta M in terms of the inner product AB was trace AB bar on D delta M. So the algebra is just this is the you have two elements, B1, B2, B3. And take the bilinear form, AB2D, A for A, and for this one, and the variant form is AB goes to take the sigma AI, maybe A1 plus so this is the size is N1, N2, N3. Then the AB is sigma N1, A1, B1 plus N2, A3, B2 plus N3, A3, B2. And by this, you have a bilinear form in the algebra. Then take the algebraic subtorus. By this, you have the complementary space of DT. Then you have a perpendicular space. And corresponding to this, you have an algebraic torus. Then define the HM term. Here, T pub is to be GM. So, this is the definition of GM. And by this, you can define the relative authority in relative choice subject. But the authority in relative testability is very rather difficult. So let me explain that. ML is a case, that definition of ML is testable relative to T is that the choice test consideration ML of ML, which is also not to T, tacky advantage is negative, non-positive, and equality, so it vanishes if and only if the ML is a product configuration. A product configuration is just the product as a variety, not including the group action. But the very important thing is if T equals T max, then the product configuration can be replaced by trivial configuration. This is a very important thing. So if you choose the T max, then that argument is very rather easy. So we use sometimes the T max in place of the general T or in place of T min. And let me explain the orthogonality in relative case stability. This is rather complicated. Apply the decomposition VM to M equal 1. So just we consider the space of gamma M. And let delta one be the group of delta one be the group of the matrix in SLP V1, acting on each V pair as constant scalar multiplication. Then the pairing defined by scalarity extends to a piecewise bilinear form defined over Q. So scalarity defined only for one test configuration, but it can be globalized. But if you globalize this bilinear form, then you have a piecewise bilinear form. And I'll explain later. And by this pairing, we can talk about the orthogonal complement of the VTR perpendicular prime of the VTR. In the delta 1R. This is the real part. This is a group of all diagonal matrices, and X is the real part. Then the test configurations of ML also granted T means the test configuration of ML associated to all possible one parameter subgroups of C1T sitting in this special linear group generated by the vector fields in this space. But not this linear space, but this is linear sub. This is a kind of piecewise linear subset. So let me explain more. So the piecewise bilinear form is defined in the following way. So for simplicity, we assume T equals T max. Let HM be the point in the Hilbert scheme associated to M embedded in PV1 by the completeness L of M. Yeah. Put delta 1 R be the delta 1 R divided by TR. This is the why we divide this one by TR, because this is the isotropy group. So actually, this acts on this Hilbert point trivially. So this one, if we divide this one by TR, then we have a group as it told us, which acts on this one effectively. And let P be the toric variety obtained as a closure of the orbit in this Hilbert. Associated to this tulip variety, we have a tongue. So this is the tongue here. Tulip variety, for tulip variety, we have a tongue. This is the general thing. So. And so you have, you can write this one, E delta 1 R BD, union of cones. So find that this. And this is the and where CJ is a single convex transversal polyhedral cone, cross cone of maximal dimension in this one, in this way. Let pi be this group is divided by this TR. So let pi be natural projection and put CJ to pi inverse CJ. Then we have a bilinear form zone, theta j, cj times epr to r, extendable to q bilinear form, theta j, dpr, delta 1 r times dpr to r, as follows.
What about the strong convexity related to normality?
Stop.
What about the strong convexity of the cone related to normality of single areas?
Some convex means some convex rational polyhedral cone. It means just this is not. I'm not so sure, but some convexity means that C1 doesn't like this. This is not convex, but I think maybe.
The only reason I ask is because you can't expect the orbit closures to actually be normal.
No. I think this is a stone convex.
Not necessarily normal to work with.
I'm not so sure. Maybe later I'll discuss with you, but convex is anyway, convexity doesn't. I don't think some convexity doesn't correct. It's not related to the singularity, but to anyway, data I think it is. But in this approach, the I don't think the convexity, some convexity. So convexity is not crucial anyway. So maybe let me proceed. And take the lattice skin d delta 1 r. And for the interior of this C1, Cz 0, Cz naught, we fix an arbitrary x in this cone. So anyway, you take x and this is the integral points. So take x and for some corresponding to this, you take one parameter group. And we consider test configuration, this, because this is the one parameter group. So you can talk about the test configuration. Success to one parameter group generated by X. And then the rho be the associated C star required morphism. We consider direct image shift. So one parameter group, you get to one parameter group. Corresponding to one parameter group, you have one test configuration. Corresponding to this one parameter group, you consider test configuration. And let rho mx to cbd associated with C-star equivalent morphism, and we consider direct image shift. And for each a and b, we define the bilinear form. Limit of m tends to infinity, trace of amj and bmj divided by m to the m plus 2, where amj and bmj are traceless part of the element induced by a and b respectively. I namely this amj is amj minus, so this will take the traceless part of amj, and this is the traceless part of bmj. And define this in this way. This is just same as the bilinear form. It's only defined for one test configuration, but anyway. It's now easy to check the following. This theta j is independent of the choice of x in this form. So if you have once you have this one, then it's independent of the choice of x in this one. And theta j and theta I and theta j coincide on cj intersection theta j. So on the intersection, theta j and theta j, I and theta j coincide. So you have two cones. You have this cone and this cone. And the intersection, on the intersection, this theta I and theta j coincide. And theta j is the bilinear form defined over here. This one and this. And hence, this theta j restrict the cj times btr glued together to produce a piecewise bilinear form on this one. So, of course, when restricted to this, it's a bilinear. But also, restricted to this sector is bilinear, but this is a piece, only piecewise bilinear. So the coincide on this line, but it's not globally bilinear on this two things. And the orthogonal complement of this one in this one is nothing but in some sense also my complement, but this is theta is not globally bilinear, so but anyway, you define the null space, take the corresponding to null space and the union of all null space, null space or null set, and this is the orthogonal complement. And in this definition, it doesn't depend on the convexity. So, as far as the definition is concerned, this has nothing to do with the convexity. So. And so, orthogonality, let me summarize the for the deductive algebraic group GM appearing in the relative choice stability, the associated algebra is the D this is a JHMR and take its perpendicular space. This is a space. And for test continuation appearing, there's a test that is close associated to all considered Isaac one parameter groups generated by the vector field in this one. This plus, this is not a space, or complementary, not a space, but complementary set. But anyway, we can define the orthogonal complement, then we can define the stability. And a program to solve the Yukes-Mackellar version. And there are three steps, step one, two, and three. Step two is, this is covered as step two. Step two means the existence of approximate balanced matrix. And I'll explain how to get such a matrix omega m. And step three, I'll explain, this is the hardest part. And key points in steps one and three, I'll explain later. And the total structure of the argument for Yukes-Mackellar version. Now that three steps for a polarized algebraic manifold, we propose the following approach. Step one, this is the general part of the and phase stability relative to T equal T max implies the asymptotic stability relative to T equal T max. And step two is the asymptotic stability relative to T equal T max implies the approximate balance matrix omega m, where m is sufficiently large. And step three is the convergence. And of course, why we need this kind of thing? Because discrete phase, then Chow stability implies that Chow stability, asymptotic Chow stability implies that the existence of balance but Yukes-Mackellar case not discrete, so we don't have this kind of thing. But this step two says that even Yukes-Mackellar case, asymptotic stability implies the existence of approximate balance matrix omega m sufficiently large. So step two, this is a paper which to appear in Osaka Journal of Mathematics. In this step, we shall show the problem. Closeness of this GM, the orbit of GM in the WM for M sufficiently large implies that the existence of approximate balance matrix omega M for M sufficiently large. I think, I explained this. And what the approximate balance matrix is, before the decomposition, we say that WM approximate balance matrix, if there exists a Hermitian metric HM for L and constant CMK such that omega M is an invariant Taylor metric under the action of the maximum compact torus of T max. And the second condition is this summation is constant on M. The balance matrix case, this is one, just one, but this is almost one, this, that the third position C. CMK is one plus O of one over M, yeah. That, so this is very small one. when emitting infinity. Whereas SK alpha is an optimal, also normal basis of V type K with respect to the metric HM and omega. And the point is how to get such a metric omega M. We consider the Fibonacci metric for M sitting in P star Vm. Here we vary the Fibonacci metric by changing the embedding of M in the projective space, namely by changing a basis for V pi k. Since the orbit GM orbit is closed in this space, we choose a point at which the chow norm takes its minimum along the orbit. So take such point, gamma. At that minimum point, at the point gamma, from the condition of the minimality of the chow norm, we obtain B and C. B and C is the minimality. So let me. Closed, so at the point gamma, you have minimum. And this is a mapping of chow norm. This is the and at the point you have. And from the minimality, you differentiate this one to all one parameter group. And derivative is zero. That corresponds to the condition B and C. The condition B and C is B and C is this one. And this we have these conditions. Then we have HM and also omega M. And let me remark the following. Then by the minimality at gamma, for the chow norm also implies that the ordinary M asymptotic Balmer kernel is written in the form Nm plus Fm times M to the N minus 1 plus O of M to the N minus 2 for some Hamiltonian function M on Nm omega M associated to a Holmes vector field in VP. And when M tends to infinity, then consider asymptotic behavior, then Fm converges. You can say if you the convergence, if you have a convergence of omega, then this Fm, you can show that Fm converges. And that corresponds to a Holm vector field. And this Fm corresponds to the scalar curvature of scalar curvature, this one half of scalar curvature. So that means that this convergence implies that you have a exponential the limit omega m, omega infinity is the extremal parameter. And the step three is let me say this is the access balance metric omega m are expected to converge to an extremal parameter omega infinity as m tends to be. Actually, this is my approach. It's very likely that the non-convergence of omega m will allow us to cook up a non-trivial test configuration, which is also going to be P max, such that F1 and L equals 0. Of course, if this is obtained, then this contradicts the k-star weight of M relative to. So by contradiction, we can prove that anyway. And for another approach, C works of chain redundancy and many people. And the key point is that let me so the arguments in step one are based on the following two observations. Characterization of F1 in terms of the chow norm. Also another thing is given a test configuration, there exists an mth root of this one. it's the test configuration such that this one is isomorphic or maybe some comparable to the ML. And that to define ML for define M prime L prime. But to do this, we need a little bit to extend the concept of test configurations. For instance, very ampleness should be modified to ampleness. So. And the total spread of the argument for its material. The ML is phase integrative to T max. So we did everything in terms of T max. Then so once you got you have the argument for T max, so this one from this to this is obtained, then this implies that this is the easy part. Shiva-L admits an X-mark error metric implies ML is case-stable relative to K minimum. This is the easy part. But this one is a trivial part. This is a stronger concept. This is stronger condition than this one. So then you have everything, all these things are equivalent. Of course, this the hardest part is the step C and D. So that's and let me except for this existence problem, the following thing is very important. For each MLT computer piece by linear form completely. Well, another thing is every final manifold MKM inverse case-stable reactive T for T max. Also, study case stability or relative case stability of M algebraic geometry. In particular, study them in relation to Aristotle Pascal's result. Well, this is done by some algebraic geometry. And if dimension, two-dimensional case for general L, CS constant scale power vector case for non-symmetric variety was studied in detail by Jonathan and then Shaw. I don't know. And the reference is this Donaldson's paper, Sketty's paper, Stockard's Sketty, and Pian. Pian's paper is the important paper. And this is the list of papers. This is the joint work between that and I modified this one to this relative stability and its two metrics. And this is the X-mark Taylor version of this easy direction. And yeah, this is submitted. And M2 is the asymptote for proliferation. This is covered the step 2. To appear in the general matter. This is all.
Is there some relatively intuitive picture one should have in mind in terms of trying to understand when a given test configuration is orthogonal to a particular torus, a particular T-man?
Yeah, I think intuitive. I think that orthogonality, so you pass to the one parameter, and in the one parameter, that's in the world of one parameter group, you consider orthogonality. So the test, so in my case, the test, every test compilation is related to, we relate every test compilation to one parameter group. And in the space, in the world of one parameter groups, I have a, we have a orthogonality. But orthogonality, for orthogonality, the orthogonality in case stability case and orthogonality for choice stability case are different. And for orthogonality in choice stability are very complicated. Yeah, sorry. But I think a very good way is to understand the also piece-sized by linear form for toric varieties. But I have no idea, sorry. Sorry. No idea.
Other questions?
Does the symphony which also imply case level?
I suppose, no. The other way. So, case table implies case table. In this sense, yeah. Relative case table implies a relative asymptotic choice. That this one, this joint work is different.
The other direction is
not true because there is a counter example by Sano. Ono. Sano. Yo. Su. Tan. Ono Sano. The counter example. By using a toric variety. Toric variety of this.
Is that counter example not asymptotic choice?
Not to asymptotic choice, no. Asymptotic case state, but not asymptotic choice state. Let me say. This direction, but not this
direction.
I think the relative case is also not. I have to think of, but I don't think this.
So I suggest that we now bring our questions to an end and ask them in private, because it will take a little while to get over to the reception of those of you who are going.